So sangat baik sampai nama mahal sayo. Aku kamu saya tu minumnya kita minyo nakakan seria tu. Of course nakakan saya memahami. So sangat baik sayo. Aku kamu saya tu memahaminya. Mungkin aku bisa bisa maybe once a week, maybe twice a week or twice a month. But what about contraceptives? How often do you use this? Every day. It's carcinogenic, according to the WHO. At the same time, next slide please. The working group stressed that there is also convincing evidence that oral contraceptives have a protective effect against some types of cancer. Well, just to be clear about it, against some types of cancer. But it causes increased risk of cancer as far as breast cancer and cervix cancer is concerned. Next slide. Humacarin users, 24% increased risk. Those who discontinued, 16% increased risk for 4 years. Discontinued for 5 to 9 years, for about 7%. And then more than 10 years, 0%. Breast cancer. Next. Slight increase in the risk of breast cancer associated with birth control pills and also probably with injectable contraceptives. Cervix cancer. Next slide. 2 times increase in risk of cervical cancer according to the Harvard Medical School Department of Continuing Education. Ito ba pinaniniwanag? Kasi pag meron kang binibiling food item, nakalagay dito. Pero ito pinaniniwanag pa sa mga pag-distribute nila. Itong mga contraceptives nito. Next slide. Cervix cancer. The relative risk of cervix cancer is increased in current users of oral contraceptives and declines after use ceases. And then after 10 or more years, you return to that of never users. Next slide. 10 years use of oral contraceptives from around age 20 to 30 years is estimated to increase the cumulative incidence of invasive cervical cancer by age 50. In the United States, U.S. incidence of cancer. Now, ito yung sinasabi ito. Possible, next slide, possible OCP death chains, cancer and hormonal contraceptives. Breast cancer, tumaas, plus 13,200. Endometrial, ito, bumaba ito, just to be fair about ovarian, bumaba, cervical, tumaas. The problem is, bumaba ang endometrial mo, bumaba ang ovarian mo, pero meron pa namang tatas mo ng breast, tatas ang cervical. Pareho din. Whether you have cancer of an organ and no cancer of another organ, it has the same effect. Parang meron mga gamot na yung cholesterol mo pababain, pero magkakaroon ng problema sa liver. And continued use of that medication will eventually give you a liver problem. But of course, they explain that, at least they explain it, that this is a complication. But in this particular case, are they explaining it this way? Especially on something that they have to use every day. Pagdating naman sa vascular effects, the hormonal contraceptives, Again, this is the WHO collaborative study of cardiovascular disease and steroid hormone contraception, 1997. Next slide. Okay, adjusted odds ratio for ischemic stroke in users of combined oral contraceptives. 2.99 in Europe, 2.93 in developing countries. In percentage. Next slide. WHO collaborative study of cardiovascular diseases, hemorrhagic stroke in women aged 20 to 44 in European countries. Per 100,000 non-users, 4.8. Low estrogen dose, 6.7. Higher dose, 12.9. Relative risk of myocardial infarction among current users of oral contraceptives, the new implantamento, Journal of Medicine. 1. Ischemic stroke among current users, 1.1. Myocardial infarction in oral contraceptive study, relative risk of myocardial infarction among current users of oral contraceptives, 1.4. New England, next slide. Other studies reported statistically significant increases by a factor of 2 to 5 in the relative risk of myocardial infarction and ischemic stroke among current users of oral contraceptives. Next slide, WHO guideline. Hypertension and concomitant use of combined oral contraceptives increases the risk of cardiovascular events. Low-dose COC does not increase the risk of MI or stroke. Pero high dose, ayaw ko mataas. Well, since this is going to be handled by another speaker.